Evan Patrice for Scripts and Scribes, and we're here at Comic Book for Free Comic Book Day, and we're talking with Chris Kawagiwa. Oh, I'm sorry, I butchered it. No, I didn't.
It's okay, it's Kawagiwa.
Chris Kawagiwa, I'm so sorry.
Okay. Teachers throughout my lifetime have always messed it up, so it's okay. It's not.
I apologize. He's an amazingly brilliant illustrator.
Thank you so much. Yeah, it's a pleasure to be here. This is one of my favorite comic book stores to come to, so it's always fun to be a part of this event.
So Chris has a comic that is very high context. There are no words in it. It's completely illustrated. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, sure. It's this one right here. It's called the Sunless Circus, and it originally was part of a short anthology that Mike here at the Comic Book put together. And there's no words to it. So basically it's all visual narrative. And the basic story is it's a robot acrobat that lives in the circus, but he wants to run away to become an accountant. He wants to crunch numbers for a living, so that's his one big dream. And when I made it this tiny little comic, I decided that I wanted to add a little handmade quality to it. So this is actually perforated, and you can actually tear out these circus tickets. And also, these barcodes, you can scan them, and there's like a hidden message inside them, too. And I've taken that story and expanded it to much longer stories. So I doubled the page count. This is 17 pages where it tells like a prequel of how the robot got built. And this is my newest one, and this is more about the Ringmaster. So it's all one big story, but they all make sense by themselves as well.
Did you find it hard to find a publisher when you didn't have any written words in your comics?
Well, published.
So oh, wow, it's self-published.
Yeah, so it was really how the Comic Book supports indie creators here that supported, you know, the group, like-minded people that brought us all together and encouraged us to do this. So it's kind of what made me inspired enough to do it, self-publishing.
Well, speaking of inspiration, what was your inspiration for the Sunless Circus?
Well, strangely enough, there's a lot of Star Wars context in here. People do lose hands, you know, so. And it is basically like a classic hero's journey, you know, like a lot of Joseph Campbell, like a lot of, it follows a lot of classical contexts. And it mirrors a lot of that sort of journey of one person coming to learning how to be a hero and taking charge of his life. And so there's a bunch of influences, but a lot of it's like the turn of the century, like Charlie Chaplin type stuff. And then a little bit of steampunk possibly, but it's a mix of old and new.
And where do you get your inspiration for your actual stories?
Oh, everyday life. I'm a storyboard artist by trade. I do a lot of music videos and commercials, so I'm always observing things to be able to tell stories like narratively. And it was a big challenge to do it like without words, but now I think I started graduating and actually trying to tell a story that with full context of what comics can do.
You've worked on quite a bit of music videos.
I have.
Do you prefer working on a storyboard where you have direction, or do you prefer having your kind of own creative space to create what you want?
Well, that's the really nice thing about comics is that you get to be the writer, the creator, the makeup artist. You get to be the costume designer. It's totally different. I mean, it's really fun to be able to like help somebody else realize their vision, and I enjoy doing that too. Especially when you get to see like, you know, really big name bands, you know, like that you've been a part of. But comics are this one thing that I really enjoy doing like on my own, and it's really fulfilling to have people read my stories and come back to me and let me know what they thought about it.
How old were you when you began illustrating?
I think as soon as I can pick up a pencil. So, you know, when you have a crayon in your hand, I just never stopped, you know.
What advice would you have for aspiring artists that want to break into the comic book world?
I think I don't know if there's any breaking in anymore. If you want to do comics, you just make comics. And I think there's less and less barriers. I think there's so many more avenues to get your work out there online, especially. It doesn't cost you a thing. And even things like this, you can publish in small runs without print on demand. So if you want to tell a story, just don't let it stop yourself, because I think you can start small. This is only 8 pages. Next one was 17, 32. So, I mean, I did it in small steps, and I think that's what helped a lot. And having a group of friends also helps a lot to keep you encouraged and motivated.